realer than a lot of you niggas.
Yeah. Hit me on my cell phone. I got it for sale. I got it from Cali. I just got it out the mail. Started with an ounce, then I turned that to a bell. The police just pull you over. You did not get that from Trail.
Nah.
FUCK12, niggas. FUCK12. FUCK12, nigga. Fuck 12. FUCK12, niggas. FUCK12. FUCK12, nigga. Fuck 12. 1600 pulled up on me, nigga. 50D. Nigga still up, put them send me down on any street. I ain't fucking with them bitches in the industry.
Nah.
I was weaving through the traffic like a centipede.
Centipede.
Drinking French vanilla, nigga, with my gang.
With my gang.
With my Rolex, nigga, with my chains.
With my chains.
Ain't gotta ask me if I changed on the same cat.
Lame.
How you wasting me no money? You can't explain that.
Bitch.
In my zone, leave me alone. Wrote a 100 songs. Still a give them what they wanted. Bleach, you coming strong.
Strong.
I would lie to prosecutor, buy another phone. With my plug, I'm speaking Spanish, need Rosetta Stone.
Yeah, stop.
Hit me on my cell phone, I got it for sale. I got it from Cali, I just got it out the mail. Started with an ounce, then I turned that to a bell. The police just pull you over, you did not get that from Trail.
Nah.
FUCK12, niggas, FUCK12. FUCK12, Nick, fuck 12. FUCK12, niggas, FUCK12. FUCK12, Nick, fuck 12. Hold up, take a trip, smoke a zip, make it flip, count a grip, take a sip, water drip. I'm the shit, you a bitch, bullshit, extend the clip. Know I got it on my hip. If that number in my phone, just know I got it from your bitch. All these niggas perpetrating, I just gotta call a hit. Remix, call a audible, I gotta send a blitz. I would take a flight to Vegas, I would risk my whole life just to put it on my strip. Me and Trey will.
Yeah, we are in the building, man. Happy Friday, man. Different mind show. Miss Fran is back in the building.
I'm back in the building. I missed you, Bam.
For real?
Yes, all this drama. What's up?
What drama?
First of all, I'm MC Fran. This is Bam. Different mind show, my bad.
Yeah, we in the building, man. So, man, look, man, we live on boxwave.com, man. God,
my boobs are in the building. You see that?
Yeah.
Not you, her.
Hey,
you
look,
see that?
Hey, look, man, we live on a different mind show, man. Y'all want to call in? The hard letters, 240-719-2560, man. We're live in the building, man, each and every Friday. Box Power 373 on YouTube, man. We live.
Same thing.
We live, man. We live in the building. So what's good? What's going on?
So
what drama I got?
I just been noticing that there's been some hate going on.
Like what?
I mean, what happened with you and this other go-go leader person?
Oh, you talking about rapper?
I don't know. Yeah, rapper.
Yeah.
What did you say that made him act so girly? Like, what was that about?
Mm-hmm.
Not even the live, but I just like read, you know, I can't like see. Yeah. I don't go look at his shit.
Oh, yeah.
But
I'm like,
you can't be getting in, you know, the go-go. Like,
I feel good, though. When a legendary dude talk about me, that make me feel real, real good. So, I mean, we squashed it. So
yeah, let's get the bands together and do like Drumline. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
like
everything, man. Don't y'all, man, tune in each and every Friday right here. Also tune in to the first, we're going to have the first Freestyle Friday. The first Freestyle Friday is going to be on February 2nd.
Which I'm excited about.
And we're going to judge it. They're going to put $20 in the pot and the winner get it on.
Oh, word? See, I didn't know there was like money up and stuff.
Yeah, I mean, well, put your money where your mouth is.
Because I'm just that girl that like is in the middle in the circle when they're all like freestyling and I love it. So I get to judge it.
Yeah.
That's dope.
Yeah.
I never get to be the judge. I'm excited. I mean, I always have to like show my loyalty to my man's is like right here, whatever, you know what I mean? But now I'm about to be
Kane,
like
what's up?
Raw. It's about to be uncut.
Yeah, I'm working on a Forever Legendary album.
Oh.
And it's gonna be hot. I mean,
I know it is.
We're gonna separate the men from the boys.
That's what's up. Mixtape Underdogs.
Yeah, I already got the song with Kenilworth Katrina, so that's going on.
Shout out to Kenilworth Katrina.
Yeah, so
she's a beautiful person.
But you got anything to say about the DMV music scene?
What don't I have to say about the music scene? What's good? How you doing? Right now, it's actually popping. I mean, there's like, what is it? Three of us that are actually Grammy nominated.
Right.
Do you know what I mean? So yeah. It's actually on the up and up and what it's doing. With that said, like now, as we're getting older, I see the turn. Like, right. As being a veteran, I see the freshman class coming around.
Yeah.
and they're changing everything.
Right.
And that's how I knew I was getting old, because it's uncomfortable. You know what I mean?
Right.
I don't know if, you know, I'm not going to hate on these young kids coming up, but at the same token, there's like a, there's a way that we do it. There's a swag that we have. And if you just forget about that and start hopping on the, what is it? What's the name of that kid? The one with the different color, 6ix9ine or whatever. And always like, you know, bandwagon, like, please don't make us look like that.
Right.
Does that sound fucked up?
Yeah, it does. That's what you do, man.
But, you know, I'm proud of this new class, new generation, but my point is to, like, reach out to the people that have been doing it for a long time.
Right.
You know, because we have a lot of, not opinions, but, like, guidance. I think it's up to us to kind of, like, give advice and motivate the young people to do, you know, they're representing us.
Okay.
So, anyway, obviously, Go-Go's making a resurgence back where it belongs. You know, everybody, you know, obviously, Backyard's doing its thing.
We'll be down in Atlanta February 10th.
February 10th.
I know everybody expected for me to be on that Backyard show, but I'm not. I'm going to go on the show the next week at Thomas Hobby, because I'm not going to ride the Backyard wave, as people would say, that I ride so much. Shout out to my man Big G, Wincy.
Shout out to Big G.
Earl. That's your Valentine.
Can you stop?
Yeah, look. I can set it up.
Kiss my ass, Bam.
You want me to set it up?
Stop.
Let me set it up.
First
man.
Of all, once I stop blushing, I don't need Bam to set it up, okay?
I'm going to set it up with G.
I've already put it out there in the universe and manifested that Big G and I will have one marriage and one divorce in this lifetime. So whatever.
So you admit that you're going to divorce him?
I mean,
if
we can make it work, but I mean... Two Tauruses. We're the same birthday. I can't be with... I tried that before. We have Cinco de Mayo as our birthday.
Yeah,
and also Raheem Devon, who we...
Yeah.
Hi, Raheem.
And also my man Stuffy, man. We want to be...
Right? So, and Chris Brown. So imagine all these people from the DMV. Tauruses rule. But all these people from the DMV have my birthday with Big G, so shut the fuck up.
How with the 8, we might do that. We wanted to make that happen this year.
So we're all going to, you, Big G, and I, and the rest of the Backyard Band. Money. We're all going to, and Andre.
I'm going to let y'all have y'all time, because after y'all, it's the King's time, man. Gemini season this year, man. We're going to turn all the way up like we always do.
Oh, Gemini? Now
me,
it makes
Steve
sense.
Roy, BJ, it's so mean. Gemini.
Everybody.
The most talented people are Gemini. Let's
Mem,
be real.
I think. The Easy might be.
Prince.
Yeah.
Prince.
My brother, yeah. Crazy.
Oh, so Candy's birthday, which was a guest here who's on live, is May 5th, too.
May 5th, yeah, Candy. Ah, so it's just the most talented people.
Are Geminis. Let's be real.
What he said.
Prince.
It's true. Talented people of the Zodiac would be the Gemini people.
You.
I mean,
thank
Kanye
you.
West, yeah. Like, think about it. You know what I mean? But nobody's better than a Taurus. I mean, Cinco de Mayo, I get free tequila. I get free Corona. Just come chill with me, y'all. I'm just saying.
Right. But before we go on with the show, I want to thank Dane. Her freedom birthday is May 24th. God damn it.
Salute.
But she's Gemini, though.
Yeah.
And Gemini, we love the fuck. I had to put that. Oh, and we
really?
The best at it.
Well, I don't know about you being the best at it. Yeah. I don't know about you being the best at it. Even we're not the best at it. We all know those Scorpios, though.
Yeah, they're not. But hey, this is what we're going to do right here. Like, but for real, man, I want to congratulate my man, DJ Honest Mike, who's not. I gave him the week off.
Congratulations.
But he had his first child.
Good executive decision. Boss.
So he was like, oh, do you want... I'm like, man, just go ahead and stay home. The baby just born a couple of days. Right? You got to enjoy your first child.
Yes.
Boy,
see, I don't... You know? I mean, I obviously wouldn't know anything about that. But I would assume that... when are we having... I'm not gonna say the name out loud. Anyway, moving forward, and no, I don't want to be pregnant. Anybody who knows me knows that.
You don't want kids?
I do want kids, but I just don't want to be pregnant.
You look like a...
Is that so
mom.
Bad? Oh my God, really? Because I got breastfeeding. Sorry.
You don't have to breastfeed.
Anyway, I'm not. Why would I want to? Anyway, this conversation is going all the way left.
No, it's not.
I am getting up there though. My ovaries are like scrambling. My biological clock, I guess, started ticking like, you know, 5 years ago.
Anyway.
Shut up! What was I talking about before I was talking about me giving birth? What was it? Damn
Andre,
it, Bam.
DJ Andre Michael.
DJ, he's having a baby.
He already had it. He didn't have it, but I mean, he's the father of it. He did the work.
Congratulations, Andre, and your wife for your baby that looks just like Andre.
Yeah, I know.
It's so weird.
For now.
Well, for well.
Because when I mean change it, they got to get a Paul Pichy.
Well, yeah, my sister had a baby. So. Thank God. So all the pressure's off of me. So I see how he grows and changes, look, but like.
Before
so
we get about, I want to look forward ahead. Next week we got the Baltimore sensation. I mean, she like the just hilarious. Right now, her, I mean, she's doing like million views, and she will be here in the studio with us next week before anybody get it. If anybody try to book your interview, hey, do my interview first, Nikki Lowe. Shout out to Nikki Lowe from Baltimore. All the funniest people coming from Baltimore.
Very true.
Yeah, she is very easy, man. She's amazing.
I love Baltimore.
And I said, you know what? You need to come on the show. That and we bring Shaw Guapo back, Young Bout there, and my man Rocco will be here next week. So we gonna have action packed. But this week. We got my
ironically,
man,
I know most of those people.
We got my man Brandon Boone from Virginia who's doing big things. Kingdom of Kings, he got his own brand.
Somebody from Virginia.
And he came to pick me up.
Word?
That's my man.
He's a true. Yeah, he's true that true.
I mean, he's doing big things. And he got all this great music that he always played when he picked me up. I'm like, man, you got to put this out. I mean, the shit.
And that's
is,
how you found
the
out.
The shit is epic. Yeah,
that's how you
but I've been doing for a long time. The shit is epic.
They're doing something different. Like, I'm telling you, I live in Virginia and I hate everything about it. But when it comes to the.
What you don't like about Virginia? I love Virginia. Virginia, where's the love at, man?
Virginia's like, okay, it's a state that's for lovers, but you know, do your thing and get out. That's what I do. Because Virginia's just like, it's, first of all, it's a commonwealth, so they're behind. It's boring. There's nothing going on. Weed is still illegal. It's like everybody's on edge, and it's just. A nightmare. People
who
can't drive.
Illegal now. We still want smoke.
I mean, I wouldn't recommend that. You don't want to get locked up in Virginia. Everybody knows that. So it's just wild. It's right. Too much, and it's just not for me. But at the same token, I love things about Virginia. My family's there, and the music scene is actually.
My family did. Also, then we got the ladies coming in here, the entrepreneurs. I wanted to do something to salute the people that don't give them music. Makeup artists, fashion people.
I'm so excited about this.
All that. Yeah. Some of y'all ladies need to watch this because y'all hair looking fucked up out there. No bullshit. Now, I ain't lying. You look, some of y'all ladies need to watch this program or how to. They could teach you or they could probably do it for you because some of these girls, y'all makeup is. The shit look like motherfucking Duncan Hines.
Duncan Hines. Sometimes they use like cocoa powder and shit for. Contour or whatever. I don't know. I love makeup.
Also, we're going to talk about, I'm going to have the Valentine's Day segment today. Because it's so many people that bash Valentine's Day. I'm like, what the fuck is the problem?
Today? We're going to talk about it?
Like, what the problem is? You love it or you like it? What, you got you a Valentine?
No, I never have a Valentine. I mean, yeah. Sometimes people will leave me, like, gifts and roses and stuff in my life, but I don't know, like a secret admirer type of thing, which is very sweet and sexy.
So you have a secret admirer this year?
I don't know. We'll see.
How about we have a win a date with fam right here on the show? No bullshit. We need to have a win a date with fam. With fam.
I feel like I'm being pimped out.
No, you're not being pimped out because I mean a whole lot of guys like you.
Really? People like me? Men like me?
Right.
Thank you. Thanks, Bam. I mean, if you want to, but they need to.
They keep asking me to hook them. I'm not gonna hook you up with shit.
Thanks. But if you, I mean, that would be actually a great thing, but we would have to be like an actual people, like somebody would have to plan a date. And you know how hard it is to get that. And I guess because.
On Valentine's Day, though.
On Valentine's Day, it's going to be so busy. So you're going to have to pick me up or Uber me there because I'm not driving.
Uber.
Through all that traffic. Yeah. And then we got to go to like Cream in DC and then go to a live show and like just actually do some stuff. I'm not trying to like, what, chill? Smoking Netflix and chill? Like, what are you
Netflix
trying to do?
In a hotel room.
Ew, it's too early. But everybody should get some booty on Valentine's Day.
Or some head. Or give some head.
Fair exchange, he means.
Hey, look, man, y'all can call in 240-719-2560, man. We got it, man. Guests on top of guests on top of guests. My man Brandon Moon, of course, he here because he picked me up. Shout out to my homie.
It's about to be a party.
And then we got the ladies out here in the lobby right now. So we just going to get real started, man. Please, all these beautiful ladies, please, y'all take it easy on my engineer, Ron. We need him for next week. All right, man. We be back. This is the Different Mind Show live on Vox Wave, Vox Power, man. We in a building, man. 40 Life. Y'all see it. Let's go.
Yeah. I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. hot on the, cause I'm stabbing on my toes, but I don't stop. I made flips out of my flaws, my side dripping on my socks with the grip so I don't pop. Plus I am your pops, cause your mom just let me pop. And I got the top, boy, y'all left that pussy hot. Gave a hell a cock, shot it up like that pussy black and I'm a car. Watch that pussy drop, hop back in the whip, took off. Swerving on the block, World Trade Center, I am not. But I'm blowing up like ISIS, cause I am the nicest. Baby girl, your MCM go two ways like a psychic. I see my future booming, nigga, I am a psychic. People don't wanna see me, but tell them please don't fight it. Light it, wait, wait, wait. All my bitches down in jail, yeah, yeah. Don't play, yeah, yeah. Pull up with the Dutty, yeah, yeah, can't spray, yeah, yeah. Make you dance and do the nay, 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 your Jono say. They only know me by my AKA, Super Duper. With the Koopa Troopers, that my nana favorite shoot you. Shall I make an atheist go worship Buddha? Call my nigga, ha ha, David, boy, you finna die. I am not the god, cause I'm stamping on my. Stamping on my, stamping on my. Stamping on my, stamping on my. Stamping on my, stamping on my. But I don't stop.
Yeah. Stepping on my toes, but I don't care. Like I got your hoe, and I don't tell. Look, I don't know, and I don't care. I just run through the money like I'm so we dollar. Yeah, look at my flow. Whoa, like a cup of foe, just for the air. Okay, now stop it. You ain't all that, so stop it. All the swag in my jeans, and I ain't talking about pockets. Niggas is swagger jacking, they wondering where they cop it. She tell me that she love me. I step back harder than harder. Now I'm out here stepping on her. Stepping on her, stepping on her. Stepping on her, stepping on her. Stepping on her, stepping on her.
But I don't stop.
Yeah, I don't know, 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 I don't know.
Cause I'm stepping on my toes, but I don't stop. I make flips out of my flops, my side dripping on my socks. With the grip so I don't pop, plus I am your pops. Cause your mom just let me pop, and I got the top. Boy, y'all left that pussy hot, gave a hell a cock. Shot it up like that pussy black and I'm a car. Watch that pussy drop, hop back in the whip, took off. Swerving on the block, World Trade Center, I am not. But I'm blowing up like ISIS, cause I am the nicest. Baby girl, your MCM go two ways like a psychic. I see my future booming, nigga, I am a psychic. People don't wanna see me, but tell them please don't fight it. Light it, wait, wait, wait. All my bitches down in jail, yeah, yeah. Don't play, yeah, yeah. Pull up with the Dutty, yeah, yeah, can't spray, yeah, yeah. Make you dance and do the nay, 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 your Jono say. They only know me by my AKA, Super Duper. With the Koopa Troopers, that my nana favorite shoot you. Shall I make an atheist go worship Buddha? Call my nigga, ha ha, David, boy, you finna die. I am not the god, cause I'm stamping on my. Stamping on my, stamping on my. Stamping on my, stamping on my. Stamping on my, stamping on my. But I don't stop.
Yeah. Stepping on my toes, but I don't care. Like I got your hoe, and I don't tell. Look, I don't know, and I don't care. I just run through the money like I'm so we dollar. Yeah, look at my flow. Whoa, like a cup of foe, just for the air. Okay, now stop it. You ain't all that, so stop it. All the swag in my jeans, and I ain't talking about pockets. Niggas is swagger jacking, they wondering where they cop it. She tell me that she love me. I step back harder than harder. Now I'm out here stepping on her. Stepping on her, stepping on her. Stepping on her, stepping on her. Stepping on her, stepping on her.
But I don't stop.
Bam, we're back on Different Mind Show.
In the building, man.
Bunch of bad bitches in the building. I'm like so excited from, you know, just the aura of bad women, like powerful chocolate women in the house. I don't get that much. Over the course of my career, I've had a lot of dudes, so it feels good to have a lot of power women in here. Thanks for coming.
No problem. Yeah. Good to be here.
So, tell everybody a little bit about yourself and where you're from.
Awesome. So my name is Relita Clark. I am from Fairfax, Virginia.
See?
And I am the current reigning Miss Full Figured DMV Queen.
Full Figured. Yeah, yeah.
Sexy.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Oh my goodness gracious. How does that feel?
It was surreal a couple of months ago.
Yeah.
But now I've kind of gotten used to it. You know, I just put the crown on sometimes just because.
Fairfax County, though. Oof.
It's tough.
That's tough.
Tough.
That's hard.
So you over there by the red zone.
What's that?
You don't know what the red zone is?
No.
You live in Fairfax?
The counterfeit crab place.
Y'all must win on the wrong day.
Shout out to my crabs from the wolf. I still come across.
So, yeah, we know what it is.
Shout out to my man Tony and all them with Red Zone. I love, you know, I used to do shows at Red Zone with Junkyard and stuff.
So long time.
The Red Zone is my spot. I like the crabs. Why you say they counterfeit?
Everybody always say, oh, they got $39.99 crabs. But you only get two at a time. You know how y'all black
folks. Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God.
Oh, yeah, that's true. That's
oh, God.
True,
that's we don't need two. We need more than that. Mm.
So what was it like growing up in Fairfax County, Virginia?
It was interesting. You know, I was around a lot of diverse individuals. I was part of the minority, of course, in high school. I actually went to Robinson Secondary School.
Okay.
Where I actually helped to start the STEP team. So I did something.
Stop. Are you serious now?
I'm so serious.
That's dope.
So serious. And it's still going today, which is awesome. So it's
Are
good
to get
see.
Up and step for us?
Not at all. That was years ago. That was some years back.
You know, I had to throw that out there.
Yeah.
How'd you do that?
It was a group of young ladies and myself that were like, hey, there's a STEP team in West Potomac. There's a STEP team in this place and that place. Why can't we do it?
Yeah.
And so we did it. We went out and got a counselor who was actually a member of Delta Sigma Theta Sorority Incorporated, and she helped us out. So we were able to get it done.
That's dope as fuck.
Yeah.
That's very cool. So out of high school, what'd you do? What'd you get started doing?
I actually went to Norfolk State University.
Hey.
Yes, I'm a Spartan. Hello, my Spartans out there. Graduated from Norfolk State in 2005.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much. I actually graduated magna cum laude. I'm very, very proud of that.
Congratulations.
So did that, and then I wasn't sure what I really wanted to do. I wanted to open my own hair salon.
Nice.
I just knew I wanted to own my own business.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's part of my legacy. You know, my grandfather actually still has, we still have his convenience store in Falls Church, Virginia.
Really?
In Bailey's Crossroads, Lacey's Grocery on Lacey Boulevard.
Oh, really? That's very cool.
Yeah. So,
entrepreneurship.
Yeah, it just runs in the family. So
wow.
I wasn't sure really what I wanted to do. So I'm a licensed cosmetologist. Mm-hmm. And then I went to, I started temping and doing a lot of receptionist work, and somebody said, hey, you want to go get your master's degree? And I was like, no, that's not what I want to do
no,
at all.
No, thank you.
But ended up going back to get my master's. I actually have two master's degrees. So I have an MBA, which is a standard MBA, and then
good.
I have a master's of education with a concentration in adult education and learning.
You're my hero.
Thanks.
Yes,
my mom calls me a professional geek. I'll take it.
I love nerds. See, undercover, underneath it all, I'm like, yeah.
Yeah.
I should have done that. Yeah.
I mean, education is one of the things that we have to teach our youth today that is going to take them to that next step, you know?
Mm-hmm.
We can't depend on becoming an NBA player or, you know, a rapper or something that in the entertainment industry that may not be feasible to them at
For
that
sure.
time. You need to be able to fall back on to something that will provide you with a foundation that will get you your money. I still secure the bag no matter
yes,
what.
Lord.
So we just have to get our youth back involved in education and understanding the importance of that.
That's what's up.
And,
yes, girl. So talk about now. Now you have gotten all of your master's and done all the schooling and you're out there thrown to the wolves. Like what are your steps these days?
So after becoming the queen, which I totally did not expect to become, I have now have a platform geared toward young women ages 16 to 25, helping them to really educate themselves on what their passions may be in life. And then helping them set that path and that action plan to move forward against those plans. Because you can do all the talking you want to do, but if there's no action behind it,
for sure,
nothing is ever going to come good out of it.
Yep.
So You know, that's what my platform is for the Miss Full Figure DMV Reign. So I actually go speak to the Boys and Girls Club on Monday, which I'm excited about. I get to sit with the teenagers and have a little chat with them, and they're going to go out and volunteer and stuff. So a lot of my days now are involving this reign that I have. So
yeah, you're a queen.
Thank you.
I'm really proud of you.
Thank you.
See, she should have been a part of the Queens.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Just say, look, everybody. Mm-hmm. Just saying, if we do a reunion or whatever, you just
y'all
come
should.
Out.
Y'all probably do. Y'all should.
Don't hate. Just say
I
yeah.
I said they should. Yeah. I'm not even hating. I didn't even get started yet.
But don't start it though. You can't start it.
Look, I'm gonna get started soon, but go ahead,
finish. So back to you.
Okay, no problem.
But no, that's dope. With the Queens, we got a chance to go and talk to some of these kids and like child, juvenile, correctional type of centers or whatever, and it was touching and heartbreaking, but empowering at the same time.
Right.
To speak to them, because we all look different. We all might be, you know, people might look at us a certain way, but we all have had our struggles and been through that.
Absolutely.
And that's what they need to hear, that you can come out on top, like.
Yeah, it just takes a little bit of work, a little bit of effort. That's all, you know. The faith of a mustard seed is what they told me, and that's what I had, and that's what grew and grew, and now it's coming to fruition for me, and I am very, very blessed.
You got like the mind of like Tupac, you know what I mean? Like,
you know, I like to think that sometimes, but nobody listens to me. So, one day,
everybody listens, they better.
That's right, from here on out.
They better listen to you because you're actually making shit happen. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah,
so,
thank you.
You're an inspiration to people.
Thank you so much.
So, when you're not like working on the youth and building a better DMV, which we love, and when you're not in school earning another,
I'm not going back.
What is your passion besides the humanitarian in you, besides the teacher in you, besides the student in you?
I believe that my purpose on earth, why the Lord has put me here, is to help other people grow and be successful. It's what I do to get paid. It's what I do when I'm not getting paid. It's what I do every single day. And I thoroughly, it took me a little while to really understand what my purpose meant.
Right.
And that comes with age, it comes with growth, it comes with understanding, it comes with experiences. And it was something that kind of flashed in front of me one day, like, you're here to help people. Believe it or not, some people are like, I heard a voice. I really did.
Yeah.
I really did.
It happens.
And it was exciting to know and understand that I now have a path, and I can see that path, and I can now walk.
I got like goosebumps and shit.
Yeah, that's what I like.
No, I think that's amazing. You know, just coming, being a part of, it's important for all of us to be a part of giving, even starting with the coat drive we have in here.
I saw that.
So please, if you can.
Absolutely.
Stop by Star Imports.
Even if you need a car like I do.
Even if you need a car.
I got to get my money up though.
But Camp Springs Road, drop off a coat. It's a coat drive, so it's always good. Using that as an example, it's important for us to show the next generation, like we were talking about, that, yeah, it's great to put us on the map. It's great to make music. It's great that, you know, we're queens and we're kings and we're doing the right thing, or we're doing our thing. But we have to bring it all back to the community.
Absolutely.
We have to do all these things that it takes to, we have to start at the core.
Absolutely.
And work our way out like a spider web. Does that make sense?
Yeah. That's it.
And it's important. Just show up. All you got to do is show up to whatever charities that's going on, whatever events that's going on.
Absolutely.
And if people really want to get their face out there and really want to be known, you'll show up to a charity event.
Or you'll show up August 25th to the Miss Full Figure
2018
TV pageant.
That's a long time.
But that's early enough to put it in your take off work or whatever.
We have auditions on the 28th. Yes. So this is our second round of auditions on January 28th. You have to register in order to find out the location. It is secret. So register, you'll find out, come audition, and then we start trainings on in March.
You think you can get me like a press pass for it?
What?
So I can.
You know the queen.
Can you give her a date? Well, that's the first thing we're gonna work on.
You can kiss the ring, but you can never touch the crown over here. But yes, please, I would love to come and interview.
Absolutely.
Like, that's so amazing.
Yeah, I'll definitely talk to my director.
I'm always hanging out with the boys. Like, can I hang out?
Come over here with us.
So you don't want to hang with us?
Of course I do.
Now you want to show up.
Sorry, I'm not. There's guests. We got company.
I was gonna be nice, but I'm not.
Sorry.
I was gonna be a different BAM 640.
Sorry.
But
I'm in all that. But I'm no, not just saying with you guys, but literally, I'm with the boys or girls who dress like the boys.
Yeah.
That's oh yeah.
I so like that. She's like, tell him to call me.
Me too.
Oh. So anyway.
Get it together.
And there's a near and dear to my, it's all good. Moving forward, BAM.
Yeah,
he's like, girls are dressed like boys.
It's on me?
Yes.
You sure?
Yes,
you
sorry.
Be nice, you
I started getting into girls and crowns and makeup and
no, for real. I mean I'm excited about the success of women because it's hard for women. Like I have plenty of female artists I work with and they always tell me, hey, you the only one guy that ain't trying to fuck me. No disrespect, you know what I'm saying? But I'm like, nah, why would I?
Oh,
I mean, it's business. I mean, sure, I'm being real. We talking about being
that's
real.
A good,
be real.
I mean, that's a good characteristic.
They expect me to be real out there.
Oh.
You know what I'm saying? They expect me to be
maybe a real gentleman.
Women still want the attention, I guess, BAM. No. I mean, if they're going to come and tell you that, they kind of secretly want
you. No, she
said
the last, dude I made a song, he tried to do this and tried to do that. I'm like,
why are they confiding in you like that? That's weird.
Huh?
They just like,
that's
a messenger. Like, what is that about?
And another thing is, I don't respond to female disses. Like, if female disses me on the track, I'm not going to respond back to her because, because I have all sisters and I was told to all respect women.
You can still respect her and.
No. Is it will not be
that's
respectful.
That's not, you wouldn't. Yeah, that ain't gonna happen. Never
will
mind.
Not be respectful.
You ain't like Will Smith or somebody. You're like, BAM. So it could get ugly. But who dissed you? What are you talking about?
OG Prank. They said she dissed me. I ain't hear it.
Get over
it. I'm laughing.
Nah.
It's funny.
If I
did a song with her last year, this year she dissed me. Ain't this some shit?
That's wild. But anyway.
Well.
Moving on. We got too many women in the building. We're talking about other random
about
women.
Ladies. No, for real. But I'm proud of the ladies that take passion in their work and start their own stuff. I mean,
for sure.
I see all different. I mean, I watch, man. I don't be having me watching all types of stuff that I don't like to watch.
Good job, bro.
But hey, but it's on the 4K, so I have to watch it. I don't can't watch that with a 4K. So I've been watching a lot of women that are successful. And sometimes I'll be like, especially like the Bow Wow show.
Which.
The show he got.
Oh, the
not the Love in Atlanta. Like, growing up.
Is it Growing Up Hip Hop?
No.
What's is that? It Grown Up Hip Hop Atlanta?
And I do not like to disrespect.
That's not the Bow Wow show. Oh, it is where he met his dad and all that.
I do not like to disrespect nobody, child.
Isn't
because
like Lil Wayne's daughter's on there and a bunch of people on it?
And she's the number one of my problems. She's number one on the list of my irritation.
You know what? Lil Wayne and what's her mother's name? They had her
Toya
when she was
Ryan.
Toya. I was about to say Tanya. Toya, right? They had her when they were like 14 years old. I mean, they really didn't know how to be but a friend to her, and that's why she's the way that she is now. And Lil Wayne's my age, and that's the reason why I didn't have kids when I was young like that, because they would be terrible, terrible human beings.
don't say that.
Hey, look.
Thanks, I'm just kidding. No. Thanks, babies. I'm just teasing. But they're like, no. Sad for me. But no, because I was so selfish, and I've done everything but chase my dreams.
My problem when it comes to women, I don't know why I haven't listened to my mother. I don't have
you had all sisters and a mother, and you didn't listen?
I'm like Rob.
Rob who?
Kardashian.
Oh,
but he got two mothers, I don't.
You call yourself a...
He got two mothers, I don't. But,
we see what you did there, BAM.
But I haven't learned that you can't win.
Oh, man.
I'm a competitor. And I still haven't got it in my head
that you
can't win an argument with a woman.
Stop. Please. You compared yourself to Rob Kardashian, who's not competitive in any way.
No, I'm saying I'm competitive, but I'm just saying that.
That's interesting.
I have all sisters.
Just saying.
He don't have no bros. I don't have no bros.
Touche, right?
So what's... I have all sisters, and we argue, and I can't win.
You're never going to win. My point is like, why are you going up against something that you already know?
No,
like,
they can pay you, but at least they know that I'm willing to speak up for my damn self.
They get beat up, I'm sure. Right. I'm sure they beat you up.
All right, my favorite internet sensation. I call it internet sensation because she always showing y'all not how to make your face look like Duncan Hines, but to make it look
smooth. We don't know what that means.
Caked up.
Oh.
Anyway,
caked up.
So, Miss Angela, what's been going on since this is my like third or fourth interview with you, and you always doing something big. So, what have you done since the last time? The last time I talked to you, you was getting ready for sending some packages off, I think to Italy or Paris or something like that.
Ooh,
yeah. Oh, hold up!
Hey! Hey, phone calls. Okay. I like that.
All right, so I'm just saying.
Okay, welcome to A Different Mind show. Who's this?
Hey, this is Andre Michael. What is
hey! Everybody get to do a round of applause for Andre. Just having a baby boy like 2 days ago.
He just had his first child, first son. Now you know.
Which apparently is
about. Have you had the middle of the night experiences yet?
Yeah, wiping ass and wiping ass.
I'm so happy
Thank
for you.
You.
I'm happy for you, mama.
Hey, happy, you got wifey on there too. So, what's the biggest, like the biggest experience you had so far that you really enjoyed?
Just seeing him come out.
Yeah, watching that was something else.
It was amazing. It's like a life change.
Well, we knew we was going to have it because he was supposed to. We almost there. I'm like, God damn, we all going to get there. I'm up here waiting. It's getting late, man.
Yeah, because he's...
Hell yeah.
He didn't want to come out. He wanted to wait for the days to get warm.
That's what I'm saying. Like, he started, like, back in December, and then he just decided, okay, now he was ready to come out, which I think is dope.
Because
it was really cold, and I'm glad that you didn't have to go through all of that. But we're really happy for you.
See, I gave I gave him the week off. I called him. I said, man, you know what? You need to stay home and enjoy this. It's the first weekend of the birth of your child. We can take it from here.
Appreciate that.
Please hurry up, come back.
It's like the third day out of the whole time I've been on the show that I missed.
Yeah, I know.
You got a real good attendance record.
Yeah, you did.
We miss you, though. We need your music.
Yeah, you know need your music, because we all got us listening to
you're the DJ.
All these 70s, he's killing us in here, man.
Hey, Ron and West, I got y'all, Ron and West.
I had to bring one
Andre,
today.
Yeah, we had to make a list of songs. We only got like 7 on there, so he's playing them on repeat. But you know what? He's doing the best he can.
Hey, I'm going to hook Ron and West up so they can have some music in my ass.
Yeah.
You know, Ron got a show in here, too. I didn't know until I seen on the website. I got to call in and talk shit to him. I got to get my headache.
Yeah, Saturday morning. It's like 8 o'clock in the morning.
We're going to slide in here to the blues show and see what's up.
Yeah.
Very different.
Yeah, right. Man. The reason I called in, though, because I saw y'all jumping band talking about females. And he couldn't defend himself because his mom told him don't hit no girls and stuff.
Yeah.
Really?
So I had to call in. I saw y'all jumping my man. Couldn't let that go down.
It is the balance.
Yeah.
The ratio to male to female is off today.
It's off today. Thank
but that's all good. Really I'm off. Happy about it.
I got my man Paul in the building, though, and my man Brandy Moon. They gonna look out for me and Ron, but Ron gonna let me get my ass whooped. He ain't gonna help me.
Nah, he's gotta press the buttons and turn the knobs and stuff.
He not gonna help me.
So, yeah, he needs you right now because he is getting beat up, but he deserves it.
What y'all doing for the first weekend? What, just gonna stay in the house?
Netflix, I don't know, probably go to like a park. It's nice. I'm about to take him outside today.
Oh, yeah, you might gotta, you gotta wait a while, right?
Aren't you supposed to put sunlight on
the
ground? Yeah, probably wait a couple weeks.
Yeah,
that's but it is nice outside.
Yeah. So sorry. Clearly, I don't know.
Yeah, man. Keep on holding the show down.
We are.
About
man.
To eat this Chipotle.
Yeah. Damn.
And I'm about to keep watching you on the big screen.
All right, thanks, Andre. Home. Appreciate it. We miss you. We'll see you next week.
Oh, for sure. Love y'all, man.
All right. Love you too, fool.
All right, y'all.
That's my DJ, man. That's my DJ.
We need
him. Don't want DMV, D-Mod.
He's the balance, yeah. So, anyway, back to the women. Get it back together.
Okay. So, as we were saying, we're going to talk to Miss Angela, but we're going to get to Crankbait. Like, this is my... I don't even wear makeup and I watch her live.
These women look beautiful.
Yeah.
Like,
she's real so...
Beautiful.
It's her. This
yeah,
right
but
here,
you have to
her.
Have, like, the foundation to build on. If you're not... You know, you're beautiful.
Thank
Sorry.
You.
I'm just like, you know what I mean? It's like, you're just gorgeous.
All right. So, Thank we be you. Right back, man. Give us a quick Crankbait, man. DJ Rob. The Blue Show. Listen to this, the Blue Show. Normally we gonna be up. So
it's gonna be lit.
Blue shit.
Stop.
Can I start breaking?
Yes.
All over my trail. Back to the base, back to the back, back to the base, like me, bitch. Man, I'm racist, no, I'm smoke like Jamaican. You hibernate on me, you sleep it. Gucci ain't high, homeboy, you trippin'. Still concealing coke in my console, so your kid folks gon' keep drippin'. I'm whoopin' that cane like I'm whoopin' my rain. Don't solve my name, just step in your game. I'ma leave this game, same way that I can. Can't wish my brother, no need to explain. Dedicate, I wasted it on my bracelet. Did one walk through, we made it. This way to remix with Baby Wayne and Kiss and I cremated it. Lifestyle might don't make it. Waste living light high every day. Click waste. Waste sipping on purpose stuff. Rolling up spanking. Waste wake up in the morning. 10 o'clock drink. Waste party party party. Let's all get wasted. Waste check it for me, baby girl. Do it butt naked. Waste I'm so wasted. She's so wasted. Waste tell the bartender send me 20 more cases.
Rockstar lifestyle might not make it. President got him in the White House naked. Looked at the clock and it's there right now. Get a pound, break it down, blow it like trout. Panatella Dutchie, wine in my tall glass. Young money, baby, big shit like a horse ass. Stacks in my backpack, shades on hatback. Bugatti back black, where they do that at? South Beach, Miami, who? I'm probably with Tame & Toe. My life is a video and the women want they cameo. I just want them pantyhose and I'm higher than Geronimo. And I got them tools, tell them boys to get mechanical.
Rockstar lifestyle might don't make waste. Living light high every day, click waste. Waste sipping on purpose stuff, rolling up spanky. Waste wake up in the morning, 10 o'clock drink. Waste party, 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 let's all get waste. Waste check it for me, baby girl, do it butt naked. Waste I'm so wasted, she's so wasted. Waste tell the bartender, send me 20 more cases.
Yo, rockstar lifestyle might not make it. Wasted just before we gon' make it. Bitches getting naked off the stones and the bracelet. Said you got coke, I bought a fiend along to taste it. Money come fast now, we ain't gotta chase it. Kush got a nigga feeling like he in the Matrix. Hennessy, Patron, Grey Goose, Aces. Alcohol, tobacco, firearm cases. Double back, double up, big faces. Tony Montana shit, crib, spaceships. Futuristic automobiles, spaceships. Jaded Kiss, laced it, remix, wasted.
Rockstar lifestyle might don't make waste. Living light high every day, click waste. Waste sipping on purpose stuff, rolling up spanky. Waste wake up in the morning, 10 o'clock drink. Waste party, 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 let's all get waste. Waste check it for me, baby girl, do it butt naked. Waste I'm so wasted, she's so wasted. Waste tell the bartender, send me 20 more cases.
Big money make a pearl handle with two clips. Cash money, young money fly in new whips. All white pearl, money from the earth. Popping Don P, iced out my baby girl.
We're back live on a Different Mind show, man. We got, man, so many ladies in here.
How you feel right now?
All y'all single or no? You single. We know you single.
I am.
We know you single.
Because you try to hit me out earlier on a date.
By the time they come along, why don't you get your little... Your roses and your candies.
I do want roses
and candies. And that's what I mean by I'm talking about. Let's talk about Valentine's Day first. How the hell did Valentine's Day get so expensive all of a sudden?
First, before we get into that, let's introduce the ladies that we have to the sides of us so people know who's here.
Okay, ladies, introduce yourself. These two wonderful ladies.
Okay, well, I'm Shonda.
There you go.
So, first timer. I am Shonda Johnson. I am a full-time makeup artist slash do health and wellness slash everything that has to do with making women just feel great and beautiful about themselves. Gosh, I don't know what else.
Okay. Okay, Angela Lewis, owner of Pretty Faces by Pretty Faces by Angela, makeup artist.
Y'all see her face?
So sparkly.
Thank you. And Glam Fix Cosmetics.
I'm all about it. Anything that's sparkly, like.
Yes, I love sparkles.
Yes. Thank you. So now we're gonna talk about Valentine's Day.
Right.
So your question is.
How did the hell it get so expensive?
Yeah,
we get cheap. It's too damn expensive.
Well, I mean, obviously, we all know that it's the Hallmarks and the candles and how they make their money every year.
But so, what's wrong with this cars and candies?
What you mean?
That's not enough these days.
Because social media took over, I feel like, and kind of made people feel like they have to present themselves a certain way. Do you agree with that? Like, for Valentine's Day, you don't think that people should.
No, I think Valentine's Day is every day.
That's right.
I have a good husband, and the holidays and stuff, we don't really get into that, but y'all every still day, go out every day. Day.
But y'all gonna go out for Valentine's Day, though, right?
Might go get a bite to eat, but we, yeah. You know.
How long have you been married to your husband?
We've been married since July, but we've been together since 2009.
See, so you've been together for a really long time.
Yes.
So in the beginning, it was probably dinners and candy and flowers and shit, and then like.
No. Actually. So I'll tell my little story real quick. So actually, no, when I met him, I was in a situation like I was homeless. So when we met, you know, he put books in my hand and taught me about business and financed my first business and gave me a home. And he was never the type to, you know, just throw money. But if it's a business I want to start, he does that, you know. You know, specific place I want to live, he does that. Like, the things that count. That's and amazing. I have five sons, so...
Oh, my God, all
he,
boys.
All boys. Wow. So he makes sure... That's my Valentine.
You don't have to worry about
coming
you.
From nothing, yeah. Like, and not having to worry about anything, that's huge to me. So
that's
the
great.
Holidays aren't...
See, the whole point of having a man is somebody that's going to build you up and make you better and finance you and make sure that you're good, so that way you're the queen to his king. That's why I'm single now, so don't even... That's messed up.
Like, no, it's okay.
Yeah, I'm just kidding. Okay. No, I'm just kidding. Congratulations.
Thank
so
you.
My question asking you that, like, sorry, Dan. But, you know, you said every day, so you go out of your way to do small things, nice things every day, so that way Valentine's Day is just another day?
It's just another day.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
But do your boys get you stuff for Valentine's Day?
I get them stuff. They spoil.
Really?
Three of my teenagers, but they're all spoiled. The oldest is 18, then we have 16, 15, 11, and 8. They're all rotten, though.
I can't imagine having, like, teenage kids.
Like, it's just like having a house full of men.
That's you don't have to worry about nothing because you got men all around you, which I think is awesome.
Mm-hmm.
But, so that then it gets deeper. So you're raising boys, and can you tell people the number one thing that you try to teach these boys because you're raising young men?
Respect.
Respect. Yeah.
Respect me, respect strangers, respect everyone. It's going to get you a long way.
Where do you live? In life. Where are you from?
I'm from Culpeper, Virginia, but I live a block away.
Oh,
I live in the area. I'm from the country.
You know, I came from Ladysmith. Don't I want to hear it? Today.
Oh, man. Oh, I know about Ladysmith.
Yes.
Got a lake house there.
Down
there.
It's beautiful. It's got its little ratchet. But I can't because I've been like Fredericksburg for a long time and all that.
I have family there now.
Culpeper? Mm-hmm. That's too far.
That's why I had to get. Yes. Ain't no money down there.
So, I had my first major show in Culpeper.
Where?
Probably at Jams, at Jimmy's.
Yeah, it was I know it was just, it wasn't even at a parking spot.
Right.
It was probably just, Jimmy's. This is when I had my go-go, man. We went down there, had a pajama party, and the Culpeper lady,
We should throw one of those. A pajama party?
Yeah.
But not like weird onesies and shit.
See what I'm saying? Pajamas. You can't have ask for a pajama party and just say, don't wear weird onesies.
I want to see people in unicorn, like, footy pajamas and shit. Like, I want to see people in
like
one.
Stop!
I
want to
see unicorn.
Yes, now we talking. Now we on the same page.
No, I'm just kidding. But no, I mean, I guess you can't really discriminate against people who want to, like, dress up like.
Why do you have a problem with
it? It's weird.
It's not weird. It's sexy.
Weird. It's not sexy.
It's what we want to see.
Wear those footy pajamas with like a little in the back of it with the two buttons and like. That's what I'm trying
to get. I just saw some of
that's
those.
That's what did you? Mm-hmm. I need to get lingerie.
Sure, I need to get one of them motherfucking old backyard Outback videos and show you.
Why are you talking about backyard again?
I just said. I said old backyard Outback videos.
Stop.
I'm gonna get you that date with Big G. You see, I'm gonna get you that date.
I don't need you to give me a date. Ma'am. I already know that. Stop, you guys, it's not about me. All right. Back to her and her husband.
She only got one husband. Not husband.
So, anyway, tell us about yourself real quick. Besides being from Culpeper, what school did you go to?
Culpeper County High School.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. So what made you move to Maryland after, obviously, Culpeper?
I was very young when I came to Maryland. A guy.
Don't
you know, I
too.
Came in this area chasing. Much smarter now, but...
So you've had your business for about 10 years?
No. My first business was a 24-hour childcare center. I had that for 5 years.
Did that really go?
Oh, I was booming. But I was tired. It was
that's
so
like,
much
that's
money.
A real thing? Like people...
4,000 a week, like roughly.
Damn.
Yeah, but kids are...
Should I need that job right now?
It was 24 hours, so people would leave the kids for the weekend. And, and then I have my own kids, so my kids are like,
hours,
Mom,
shit.
Hello. Yeah. So I got tired and just wanted to do makeup.
I did daycare before. I did that show, like, just a few hours a day, and I was
Lord
like,
have
no.
mercy.
No, it's sad, though, because when you, like, raise them to, or not raise them, but you teach them to, like, use the potty or tie their shoe or whatever, then they like grow up and they take them away.
Mm-hmm. You get attached. That's the bad part.
I can't do it. I can't do
Some of them I was glad they were gone, but
yeah, for sure.
There was a few. I had a few favorites.
Yeah, kids are bad all the way around, but they're honest and they're good hearted.
They're sweet.
But, you know. Anyway, so you have that business and then.
Now I have the makeup artistry business, and I have a cosmetic line that I recently started about a year ago. Okay. We'll be adding them soon. I don't have them yet, but we, of course.
No, I'm just kidding. But no, I would love to support you. The whole point of having these women is to show everybody locally, like, look what we already have. Because I hate to, like, because I'm filming a documentary, all these different things, and, like, I don't want to have to keep putting a post, like, can anybody link me up with this person? Like, yeah. I want to already be able to pick up the phone and call you, and pick up the phone and call you. And
create a network.
And call her and find full-figured women to wear your clothes or do your makeup or whatever. Do you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And this is an amazing thing. Now, what we should do is come together and do something.
Collab and do something.
Have y'all ever think about teaching classes, the profession y'all do? Like,
I do offer classes.
You do?
I offer one-on-one. And I'm thinking about doing something big, like where you sell tickets. The classes are $300 for one-on-one. Mm-hmm. Yeah, my kit is very expensive.
I'm sure it is.
So if you do a class of like 10, how would you do?
Well, I would sell tickets. I would rent a venue and sell tickets, and we have a big old...
Like a seminar.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Give away goodies. And since I have my own cosmetics, that's easy. I don't need a sponsor for that. Mm-hmm. Just give away swag bags. And
so I can host it, and they can all set up.
This is what I want to know.
Yeah.
This is what I want to know. Do y'all see people online with bad makeup and say, damn, I want to help out so much, but I don't want to offend her?
That's like the nature of the beast.
I've learned to be humble.
Yes.
I mean,
because
everyone, you do.
Because
some
shit
look fucked up. I'm going to just be honest.
But everyone starts somewhere, you know. If anything, you know, if you far as we've gotten in the game, then you help.
Right.
Like if someone is struggling, you help.
See? It's just, you know. Ours is with music and media and this and that, and theirs is with their makeup and their foundations and things like teaching people.
Yeah, and I go live a couple times a week on Facebook for free just to help ladies with eyebrows and basic things.
Yeah, I see that. I watch
you
it.
You know,
I'm
I don't charge for it. I'm about to find out how to charge for it, but I don't charge for it right now.
Sponsored.
Yeah, something.
But that would be dope, I think, that we should do.
Everybody.
We need to have a fashion show.
And I teach you how to walk.
There
yes,
go.
Please.
Strong.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Feet.
Sorry.
Some girls' ass is so big they don't even need to learn how to walk.
Well,
I cannot be honest.
I have anything against women with big asses, but it's like the diaper effect when they're fake. Like grossness me out.
I don't like that either.
It's weird. Like if you're getting injected, when you get it in your thighs too, so that way it's not like a diaper.
I used to mess with this girl that used to put ties under her leg. Like, the ties under her leg just to make her bust it up. I said, I ain't mess with
that. Well, I think that happens because they try to, you know, go around instead of going to the good doctors. They try to go over to Columbia and stuff. Go to the good doctors.
True.
Drop $10,000. If you're going to do it, do it. Don't try to, you know.
Basement in Miami.
I would never, if I was to get surgery, I'm going to Dr. Miami.
But why get surgery?
Miami.
You know, he's known.
Some of these girls look. So,
but you look good though.
Like, it is some beautiful black women out here. I don't like what would make them even try plastic surgery, like Lil Kim for instance. Like, she didn't need it.
I'm not talking about her because that would get me in trouble.
Lil Kim, you know,
I'm not talking about anybody on Bad Boy.
She's still beautiful,
but can't, you know, she is a beautiful woman and she chose to change the things about her that she didn't like. But I will always say that I think when Tupac called her ugly,
that's what happened.
That's what I felt. It's just
well,
like publicly
sold. He's a Gemini, man. We were certain, be serious about our shit. We just talk about, we just at the moment type
and
people.
That's your point is, I feel like, is like, you can do plastic surgery, just don't do it to that extent to where it's like body dysmorphic disorder.
Right.
Is that the name of it?
Mm-hmm.
You feel, you know.
Well,
like,
you know something's been done.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's like, you know, you're changing everything that your whole nationality, like ethnicity, like that's a little, that's a little weird. Or like, what's her name? Miss Nation. Anyway,
yeah.
Sorry.
Another question I always wanted to ask is, what is so special about lipstick that make a woman stand out in a line early in the morning? I saw that and I was like,
it's colorful. Like, we're attracted to
you standing out there for lipstick. I mean, the line is like a street one.
Makeup is an addiction.
Yeah.
Like, why was it that long? Like, I thought it was Black Friday.
It's worse than a gamble.
It's because it was free. That's what it was. It was because it was free.
A woman was staying in line for one.
Oh, yeah.
It was free. And the crazy part was they were like blue and green.
They were like, these are the colors we want.
I'm going to wake up and they got them. They got them. They don't. They don't.
But sure. You just made your own point. Men stand in line for shoes and clothes and whatever, and even men too stand in line for makeup and so like with the women or whatever. But you
I'm
know,
an impatient dude. I don't like to stand in line for nothing.
Well, I won't stand in line for anything.
Me either. Okay. I don't like it.
I'll just wait until it drops and I'll just be ready to
only
order.
Only one I stand out will. I'm not. I don't even stand for my groceries because I love to eat. I'm standing in line for that.
But you didn't order online.
Yes, sir. You're right about that.
I'm standing in line for that.
The formulas of makeup kind of gets better, and the pigmentation of things gets greater, and makeup changes. It's evolving, and some people, as makeup artists, that's like get you hard, like if you know what I mean. A new palette comes out, or
oh my gosh,
a new concealer, a highlighter, like
every month. Whole at life, this point, whole, yes. Whole life.
It's, and whole that's life. The, that's what makes them money. The better their makeup is, the more money they make. You said,
and that's where I want to go with my line. It's very expensive to have a line, but eventually, that's where I want to go with it.
But you raise successful now.
How'd you start that though? How did you start this thing? I mean, that's expensive, but you know, you have to go through a lot of like test kits and things like that.
You do your due diligence. You go through a lot of back and forth with the distributors, and
you gotta get put in little stores and little places.
I'm not there yet. I'm e-commerce, but I ship over to Kenya and you know.
So you do live videos and stuff?
Mm-hmm.
You do live video all the time.
A couple times a week if I have time.
Okay, so I'll definitely.
See, I think you should do well, you are busy women because people look to, I mean, the live videos, as soon as you put them on, it's like all these people like chiming in. How did that make you feel?
Let me, that's a good question, man. Like, how do you deal with all the haters? Because live video, people are ruthless.
You know what? I don't deal with that on mine. They don't come and say mean things to me.
I have like three moderators just like.
I'm like friendly to everybody. I
wouldn't say nothing to you. See, if you got a big guy like that over there, I wouldn't say mean things to you either.
There you go.
People are nice to me.
True enough. Like, they're
nice. They're nice to me. I've never dealt with that yet. Yeah.
We're not going to manifest that on you either.
Right. But if I do, you just ignore them type of people. I mean, there's no point in really.
Man, I just, every interview I say, I wish he could help some of these young women with this makeup, because I be saying it like you really thought you look good coming out there like that? And you in a go-go, so once you sweat, it's going to
not the
go-go.
When
right when the lights
come on.
Right when the lights talk about that.
Does sex mess up makeup? I'm asking for a friend. I'm just saying.
I don't know.
I don't get it.
Yeah.
Anyway, back to the
no, we on this one right now.
You mean like regular makeup or like porn makeup?
Anything.
I'm just asking.
Anything.
Any kind of makeup, of course. Yes.
Well, anything will mess up makeup. That's why when your face is done, you don't want to be, you know, you want to be in your own bubble.
Unless
like,
it's
don't
like
come
a
near me,
your
don't.
Anniversary or
yeah.
His birthday.
Like that.
So
not, you know what? My husband is not too crazy about the idea of always having on a full face of makeup.
No.
He's like, you gotta put that stuff on today.
Yeah, I mean, obviously, like, he knows that that's your.
But I'm a walking advertisement, so yes, exactly. I do it every single day.
But naturally, when you just get out the shower, get your hair up in a towel. Your husband loves you.
He loves me that
You're
way.
Perfect.
Great guy, man. Great guy. And I'm gonna tell y'all a story when I got ripped off of my apartment. Cause people do scam. I was out. I ain't nowhere to go. Like I was out. Like I was actually homeless. I said, I don't know who to call. Then a ring, I said, dang, when I seen her picture, I said, oh, that's who I'm gonna call Paul. and the man reached out hard for free. Didn't want no money enough. It was giving me all these places. And he told me to try one place, and that's why I got a condo right now. Because of this guy.
Awesome.
And I thank him for that money for that. So if y'all need houses, he been selling them like crazy, ladies.
Like hotcakes.
It's been going. So how did it make you feel his success and how good he is to people? But that's probably one of the reasons why you married him.
Yeah, I look up to him. Like I feel like I can't make any moves without him. Like he's my advisor. Like I go to him about everything. I just feel lost if he's not right there for me to check in and make sure these numbers are right or I'm doing this. Like he's everything to me. I don't know. It's
See, he that's like me. I'd be like, God damn, when you was gonna tell me you was gonna spend this much money?
Man, he fusses at me.
That's why I understand about ladies. Why when a man give y'all money to go to a store, say, y'all don't give me back my change?
Oh no, ain't no change.
That's why.
Right, why
ain't
no change. Is that? What happened to the change?
That's her tip.
Like this shit came up to this butt. Like, where's the change?
It's cheap.
You know
you
what?
Can't be cheap, damn. You can't be
cheap. It's you're just definitely being cheap.
You should.
And then when we argue,
I feel like you're supposed to get.
And then we argue. First thing he said, I don't see you cooking shit in. It's no secret. I can't cook.
You need to learn or something. Do something to make up for it. But she's supposed to get your whole check or something, I think.
Whole check? Shit.
I don't know. So I'm just throwing that out there. But when you're, let me talk about your videos, though, that you do when you do makeup real quick. When you do that, do you just kind of like sell your things while you're doing it? Is that legal to do?
Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Like,
okay.
I'll post something. It's like gone in like 10 minutes.
You sell out.
Like, I just watch the money coming through.
Oh my god!
It's gotten to that point.
And they can order stuff. So how can they get it?
Glamfixcosmetics.com is the website. And if you're local, you can just holler at me. I deliver.
Holler at a
stuff.
Player. Yeah.
Show you how to use it. All that.
Dang.
That's dope.
Okay.
I'm very excited about that because I get to do girly shit. So anyway.
Oh, so you don't like do manly shit.
I do too much
like
manly shit.
Tidy
up. Change attire. No, get my nails done. So men should like do those type of things.
I seen a girl doing that shit one day. I was amazed. I'm saying,
no,
I'm surprised.
I wish I would have gone to school so I would have to like be dependent on men to help me and shit, but like, cause y'all are.
You probably don't even know how to check.
Y'all complain too much.
Check your tires, dude.
I do know how to do all the basic things, but this isn't about me. Let's get back to the ladies. So let's talk about you real quick.
Yeah.
So again, tell everybody like, you know, a little bit more about you so that way we can.
So again, I am a full time makeup artist. I actually work for MAC.
I do work for MAC.
I've been there for almost like 5 years now. So it's like I actually go in and all that good stuff, but I do makeup on the side. I feel like most makeup artists do makeup on the side. Like you just kind of
it's your hustle.
Absolutely. So I do classes and, you know, a little bit of one-on-one. I feel like I'm kind of all over the place because in addition to that, like I am doing like a health and wellness business. And with that, so I have like it on my like Instagram and all that stuff. I am talking about makeup 1 minute, next minute I'm talking about teaching you how to lose weight. So it's a little bit of everything.
Did you lose weight before?
I am losing it now. Yeah,
right
now. I need
to do that because I need to lose weight because I got diabetes. No, that's where I got diabetes.
Yeah.
You gotta learn how to lose weight. And I don't know how to control my eating habits because I like to eat.
You can still eat the things that you like, but in small.
And the doctor said, hey, you should roll up the steak. Steak, man, you crazy. I'm 22-ounce porterhouse in my face and you talking about steak.
You know, yeah. I'm always happier when I'm heavier, but at the same token, it's just like easier, you know, when you start to lose weight and feel things.
Feel better.
You feel
so
better.
Much
yeah.
better, yes.
So it's been really hard because I changed my whole diet and everything. Mm-hmm. And, you know, just more, you know, red meat, you know, and all
no
that type of
meat.
Stuff. And trying
we
to,
gave up meat.
It's
now.
Hard.
It's like 6 months.
Yeah.
We eat seafood. But.
That's what I'm saying, like the pescatarian style. But it's a hard lifestyle change. But once you see the
once
results.
You start to see the results, absolutely. So in the beginning, I feel like it's kind of hard, but you kind of push yourself and just say, you know what, this year, this New Year's resolution is really going to be a resolution.
Mm-hmm.
I started last year. And right now, I am over 50 pounds down.
Wow.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Oh, it has been hard, by all means hard.
Hey,
but,
I'm going to ask you a serious question. People don't think I'm going to be funny. Everybody in the room going to laugh like they always do. Is sex considered exercise? Because I'm doing a lot of work.
Oh,
and
my
I'm,
God.
And I'm,
you can ask the question without giving us a visual.
I mean, you do
work for who?
You work on the calories.
You're saying that you're doing all the work?
I'm just
is that
saying.
What you're saying? Or it's too much work?
I'm sweating though. Like, hold on, give me 2 minutes. Let me get some Kool-Aid. Look, man.
Why Kool-Aid?
I'm working.
You should be drinking Kool-Aid if you got diabetes. Baby.
Okay.
I'm working.
So you shouldn't have any problems with your weight loss then if you're like doing all that.
Is that considered exercise?
Yes.
It is.
Okay. It is.
Mm-hmm. You can lose weight by having sex.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And you can, you know, just kind of, what is it, like good cardio?
It's cardio, mm-hmm. It is. But to burn a lot of calories, you have a lot of sex. So, I mean,
and we know
how
that.
I'm not trying to just go jog.
I know we're getting too old for it. Yeah. You know, well, I'm willing to try.
Yeah.
Bam, what else?
Nah, like, out of, I'm gonna ask both of y'all this, out of your grind, like, what do you want to achieve? Like, what will be the final goal? Excuse me if I come on, but hey, I'm a ratchet host. I admit, I'm a ratchet host. Shannon looking over me, my man, like, she gonna put her head down, but hey, I'm ratchet. But hey, I'm the DMV host of the year, so I'm ratchet for a reason. But anyway, like, what are your, like, major goals, like, do you want to achieve? Like, when it's all said and done, you will say, okay, I achieved a goal when I started this grind or whatever you do.
So, at the end of all of this, my goal is to pretty much open up a business, or I'm thinking more so maybe nonprofit, and at least in the beginning, where I am, like, helping style women with clothing. We're talking clothing, hair, weight loss, and makeup.
So, like a lifestyle brand.
Yes, pretty much. I know, like, for me growing up, I was, like, always, like, plus size. And that was great. Like, I never had a problem. I never thought anything was wrong with it until you go to high school and all that, and you kind of see a whole mm-hmm. lot of other things. And you're like, okay, well, wait a minute. What's really going on here? And I just remember I used to cry. And because I have a sister, she's, like, size extra small. But, you know, and so she's like, well, Shonda, you're not, there's nothing wrong, and da-da-da. And so what I've noticed is that when she would meet women who would say that, oh, well, maybe I can't find anything to wear, or I don't feel pretty, she was like, you know what, you should talk to my sister. And then I just started feeling like, okay, well, girl, what are you doing? Like, you don't even know these people. You're talking to them. You're uplifting them. You're telling them, oh, you're beautiful. You don't have to wear makeup. Like, this is going to enhance, like, things like that. So, overall, for me, I am up for, like, uplifting women, making them feel beautiful. You know, if you want to lose weight, that's great. If you don't, it's no problem. Mm-hmm. But, you know, just all about, just for me, it's always been, like, a love for people.
Right.
Yeah, so.
And that's just something you inherently know. I know what that's like, because people are my thing.
Yeah.
But yeah, I think that's an amazing thing. And just what you said, too, I think 2018, because 2017 ended up that way, is the year of people just embracing who they are.
Themselves, yes.
And their weight class and their skin color and their hair texture.
Absolutely.
And, you know what I mean?
I love it.
So as long as you feel good about yourself, that's beautiful. That's beauty.
Mm-hmm.
So that's dope. Giving them the motivation, all of you women, like empowering women,
yes,
you know?
Absolutely.
And so 2018, I feel like can just go, like there's going to be so many more black women doing the Oprah thing.
Yes.
You know what I mean? Especially out of where we're from, because we can't fail. Cause
Oprah for president, by the way, man.
Why?
Come on, Oprah, get in there.
Oprah for president.
I think Oprah should not be president.
Yeah, I think she
I think Oprah is in her own lane.
Oprah
for
president.
Need to be
anything
touched.
Anything better than goddamn what we got now. That looks Oprah for president, man.
Speaking of Oprah.
No comment.
You bring Gail in. Gail ain't got that much clout, right?
That's she can make some things happen, though. My end goal is to be retired in 6 years.
Yeah, I mean, that's good.
Retirement is my end goal. Like, I want to be a makeup guru. I want to go speak to young girls and stuff, but mm-hmm. I want to be retired by the time I'm
you like me. I just want to
say, like,
my
you,
hallelujah,
hallelujah.
And that's my goal too. I just want to wake up and just do music, makeup, and do
just
radio.
Do what you
I just
want
to do.
Ain't gotta worry about no bills.
I just want to do that.
And you can do that. You can literally do everything you've ever wanted to do. You have to set that goal and just do it. You know, it's smash it out of the park.
And that's why I watch reality TV so much, because I'm not a hater. Like, I can't hate on nobody's success. I watch the Love and Hip Hop and all that. I just want to know the problem of being successful, because it's a big ass problem.
Ain't no problem, it's a breeze.
Yeah, talk about it.
Just stay in your lane, like, ain't no problem.
See, me, like, some of them people be on shows and they be all respectful, fake, not me. I'm like, nigga, fuck you. Fuck him.
Oh, Jesus.
This is what I'm going to do.
Ooh.
Yeah, I mean, that's what I'm going to be a straight up person.
And that's fine, because that's Bam's lane.
Yeah, I said it. Yeah, well, I mean.
These people on these reality shows, man,
they
sell
fake.
Their souls.
Yeah.
Man. There's
yeah.
no way I'm going to be
That's integrity. That's what all it is. That's
and then I be trying to tell.
It's integrity.
That's ridiculous.
And then I try to tell Mom. Y'all, and I tell Ronnie this all the time. She come, oh, here you go with this Illuminati talk. I'm like, that shit real.
They sell their souls to somebody. But yeah. I'd rather earn it the old-fashioned
way. That
shit
real. Yeah, me too.
You know, that's mm-hmm, just
most
that.
Definitely.
So if we did a Love and Hip Hop DC...
Well, besides... If I'm in trouble, Ray's going off the roof. I'm
besides...
Because I'm going to do me.
Mimi. And besides... who's the other person right. that... is a part of the DC. Oh, Snoop. Besides Be More Snoop and besides Mimi, who do we think
Shout out
would
to Be More
be,
Snoop. That's the
yeah.
homie right there.
Who
That's
do we
homie.
Think that That's we would put on that show?
I don't think she should be in New York. And Ronnie Man talking about she in New York. Nah, she from Baltimore. They can do Baltimore here.
That's the
be
point
over
of
there.
The.
Get off there, Snoop.
If they
I'm
going
to call you too. I'm going to call you too, Snoop.
If
hey,
they
look,
did
a
Love and Hip Hop DMV version, who do you think should be on there?
I don't know, but I know who should be on the Flippin' DC version. Flippin' House.
Okay. So let's get back to that.
I'll be on that show.
Tell everybody the name of that business.
He's the DC house flipper.
Tasty.
So he buys properties in the area and flips
right.
and resells and all that good stuff.
So if somebody's looking for that, which is
Yes, he's
like,
also a realtor.
And he's straight up. And he's straight up.
Yeah, he helps. He helps a lot.
No,
this one is a gun zone, this one is not. Which means, bam, you're going to need your gun in this room, but you're not going to need your gun in this one.
Uptown. It's Uptown people for you.
He's Uptown. Yep, he's from Uptown.
No, I'm just kidding. But no, that's a beautiful thing. To invest in properties and flip them is a very, very smart thing to do.
Mm-hmm.
And we don't see... I mean, there's a place in... Baltimore actually offers
I'm not
that.
Baltimore.
Where you, of course, obviously not. My, that's
Baltimore
where I'm going with
dangerous.
This. Where you can buy a property for under a really, really low amount of money.
Oh, yeah.
A dollar sometimes. If you want to fix it and then flip it. But you, I guess what? My mom said, because she was a real estate agent, that you have to flip it in a certain amount of time and have people live there in order for it to be.
I guess it will be rules when it comes to that. Mm-hmm. I guess.
Is it rules when it comes to that? It's different. Like, they just put that back out there. But
that's what she
they
said.
They only wanted to be for residents.
Baltimore residents.
Oh.
But then what about Baltimore?
D.C. with $1 million home.
Baltimore don't even have
Yeah, touche, yeah.
You know.
We got... Baltimore, you know why Baltimore is so messed up? Because all the women
Tell
get
me.
In a relationship on chat lines. That's why it's so messed up. Baltimore,
oh
get
God.
It together. For real.
I don't know anything about chat lines. You
have
know
you
so
ever,
much
hey,
about
listen,
them.
Listen,
so I don't...
If you in a group... You in a group? I'm in plenty of sex groups. I'm honest.
I'm dumb.
Mostly all of them from Baltimore. All the people in sex groups, they from Baltimore.
All right, good to know. So
you in a sex group, right?
No.
Don't worry about what I'm gonna add you tonight. No,
I'm gonna be blocking Bam tonight.
Yeah.
No, I don't know. She's like,
shoot me.
She's doing like the full figure women, just smile and wave. Just smile and wave. Bam. Anyway.
Bam, they're corrupted.
I know. Like, I was never like this before I talked to Bam. Did you? So, any more questions for our ladies here before we? Go on to,
I just want y'all to say where y'all can get all y'all stuff from and where they can follow you and what a bitch y'all got coming up and keep us intact because we'd like to announce them on the show and promote them and that's what it's all about. Shani is real upset with me, but I really don't give a fuck. Anyway, go ahead with that.
You can get my cosmetics from glamfixcosmetics.com.
It's tax season too, ladies.
.com.
Don't buy them man them Jordans.
Like,
don't
camera.
Buy. Hey, get your shit
camera.
Right. Get with her before you go buy. And ladies, please, tax season is real, man. Don't let a nigga use you for your tax shit. You work
invest
all year
Invest your
off.
Money in tax
yeah,
season,
please.
Ladies.
And you
get your
swear.
Tax money
That's
and
right.
invest it.
Yeah.
Those of you who have kids, getting back like $7,000, $8,000, $9,000.
I'm
going
to start my
like,
kids a business.
That's wild.
I'm sick
Why
of
should
bacon.
I be punished because I don't have kids?
Work, make your own money. It's time.
No, the right thing that I saw a woman do, obviously, was to teach her son about paying bills.
Right.
You know what I mean? Investing in things.
My aunt did
and
this
all
shit.
That type of stuff.
I did that to me growing up when I had a job. To my mom, you how to pay bills. But guess what? How you teaching me how to pay my bills by paying your bills? She said, I'm trying to teach y'all, like, we'll pay this electric bill.
I mean, you can't spend that if that's
there you go.
Man, my teaches you. Good. Hey, look. Aunt Jane, I love you. I know you watching. She gonna come. Are you talking about
I hope
me?
She's not watching you act like that.
I hope everybody, my women going up, Aunt Jane.
That's why they invite me to their wedding. They know I was gonna join everybody drinking shit all up.
There you go.
I just say congratulations. They say this shit. Look, bam, they come across my nigga on Facebook. Don't invite that nigga to nothing. That's why they call me the host, because I'm a joint.
Okay,
shit.
We believe you.
Like the big girl Bam who heel broke at the last my last show, her heel broke. She was dancing. I said she was dancing too hard.
Why was she dancing? She was,
not her heel.
She was dancing break. Too hard.
Here?
Yeah.
In here?
No, at the show I was hosting.
Which one?
The Go Go Show. Failed, the show.
She failed Bam.
Yeah, she. Took her shoes off. Took her shoes off and got back to it.
All right, so girls, drop all those social media addresses and websites real quick. So we can take a quick break and come back.
Okay, so social media, definitely on Facebook, it's just Shonda Johnson. See me. I know it's probably a lot of Shonda Johnsons out there. But Instagram is Redbone.
Redbone
81. And like I said, and, I will go ahead and give you guys my health and wellness business.
Right. I'm going to need that.
That one is Success Suits You. I actually work for It Work, so you guys probably have heard of that.
Oh, yeah.
So the website, that one's Success Suits You. MyItWorks.com. So yeah, but I always say, like, send me a message, or, you know, we can definitely chit chat about makeup, you know, health goals, any of that. Like, I'm totally up for it.
And that's nice too. Give yourself to other people, you know, also. People just need help and advice.
Yes.
That's a good thing. Thank you so much for that.
Yeah, thank you.
And my Instagram is prettyfacesbyangela_MUA. That's one of them. Mm-hmm. Then we have Glam Fix Cosmetics. That's another one. I own a few other businesses, but we're not going to. Or should I?
Yeah, go ahead, network.
It's your moment.
Okay, well, I own a beauty concierge where I'll send a team of folks out to get you ready for a bit.
That's nice.
Barber, hairstylist.
Why you ain't tell me?
Because, you know, I'm still working, Bam.
Oh, shit, let me get with that. Let's do it.
And I also own a exotic cleaning company.
And what's that mean?
What does it mean? Well, it means we send the maids out to clean nude for the rich men.
Oh. Man, I need my shit clean tomorrow.
Why
about to start work? I only need 1 hour.
Wait, all nude? Like, they don't wear anything?
You can choose. It depends on what you can afford. So the nude is the most expensive, and then you have the lingerie, and then
just a maid's thing, but...
Well, they do party hosting, they do bartending, and they do...
You know, I've been a bartender for 20 years. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to get naked. I'm not. I'll be the price goes down a little bit because I'll have some clothes on.
Well, yeah.
But I would love to just go out randomly to, like, bartend.
Man, you can't let them Jones hang?
Let's do it.
Don't even come.
I'm not...
This is the Jeremiah Show. Thank these ladies for coming, man.
Thank you, ladies.
Brandon won't come to next. We're going to take a couple of pics, man. I was just being me. But I bet the views up, though. I bet you that.
They stay up.
All right, okay. Let's go.
Different mindset.
Girl, just come on with me. You ain't a passenger side when I'm driving, girl. You kissing all on me. Licking my neck with my hands on your thigh, and I'm making that pussy leak. Know just what you want, cause you ain't had dick in a week. And I know that you a freak. Oh girl, I know you're down for playing. I know you're listening to what I'm saying. Your body done started up this conversation. Did you really take this inside? When I'm inside, yeah, let's get it. We party all night, then you leave in the morning. Girl,
pussy too soft, then you get it again in the morning. Girl, I know you're down for playing. Ooh, yeah. I know you're listening to what I'm saying. What I'm saying. Nobody done started up this conversation. Oh, no, 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 no. Cause you really take this inside. When I'm inside. Yeah, let's get it. We party all night, then you leave in the morning. Drop funds on some new shit right now. I ain't talking yesterday, I mean right now. New Audemars for you in this iced out. Lingerie on, got you all wipey down.
Where you wanna be right now?
Ride it on top, now you all on my top.
Who she wanna be right now?
Got you all in my palms and that ass is the bomb. Versatile, got your Versace on. Fur on the couch, lips off, fresh out the shower. 25th hour, eat it like Philippe Chow. Lick it down, yeah, use your mouth. Light up a blunt and we zone to the moon. Yeah, back to the sex and performing. It's time I make sure it's recorded.
Hey, I said it. Call me on the phone and she open up the door. I be skipping all the kitchen, get to hitting it on the floor. Get it. Take it to the kitchen, so many different positions. Bitch. Fuck her real slow, she talking, I like delicious. Get it. On the road with it, she don't like to pay attention. All this money on my mind, but the pussy what I miss. Get the penitentiary, I'm left wrist whipping. Sneaking, we freaking, no sleep on the weekend. But I just wanna hit it by the leg, from the back, from the front, where I'm gripping on the page. On the page. I just wanna give her what you can't. Fly all around the world, popping bottles of the A's. Of the A's. I just wanna take her to the bank, shopping trip. What you get? DC, LA, LA. I should let her meet CB. He a free. She can get my young nigga what he need. Let's get it. Let's get it. Let's get it. Let's get it. Let's get it.
I know you listening to what I'm saying. Your body done started up this conversation. Did you really take this inside? When I'm inside, yeah, let's get it. We party all night, then you leave in the morning. Girl, when you ride it, act like you performing. You a bad motherfucker, you the shit right now. Play your position, we switching positions, lights out. You a bad motherfucker, you the shit right now. Play your position, we switching positions, lights out.
Bought three long pies. She from Rhode Island, Atlanta, I reside in.
Asian, black, Caucasian, a blazing, persuasion, so amazing, it's amazing how they stand there, cause they're patient, waiting to the perfect time for conversation. My observation, tell me that she's with your baby, baby. To four lanes in that 09 range while I'm singing old Trey. It's like this all day. Okay, my name's Wale. They probably know me from the, you know, Boss in my Hugo. Floss like my twofer. My flow is on Pluto. Them rollers ain't Pluton. Having beef on who gon' twist up my new roof. Yeah, shorty, that's G. Tokyo spinach. Yeah, shorty, that's G. Please get hip to that new DC shit. I'm a PG. I ain't finna keep them. And I be with P, so I got BBC. Even if I didn't, I would ball like Arenas. Swish. Now, shawty, this is what I need from you. Live for tonight before tomorrow's amnesia. Yeah.
Niggas bow their heads with dignity.
Beat mechanics.
I want all shooters at my funeral. Only real niggas at
gangsta
my funeral.
Gangsta grill shoot.
It's gonna be 10,000 bitches at my funeral. Niggas gonna have them pistols at my funeral. It's gonna be some superstars at my funeral. Driving in exotic cars to my funeral. Niggas that whip that brick of hard at my funeral. You might get your ass robbed.
Work out.
y'all. We back live on A Different Mind Show, man. It's been a great show, man. It's been a great show.
Lots of fun.
Heavy. But we ain't done with you motherfuckers. Like that dude said on what the fuck? I'm going to talk about that later, but...
We'll talk about it later.
But I don't know about one of them didn't like him, but he was like... The first joke the comedian said, he said, I knew my daughter was going to be a hoe because when she was young, she used to squirt the fuck out.
All right. So let's introduce the two new people that we have sitting next to us real quick so that way everybody knows who's here.
Hello, I'm LA of Royal House of Style. How y'all doing?
Doing good. Thank you. Right. Tell everybody here a little bit about yourself.
I mean, I'm L.A. I'm the owner of Royal House of Style. I'm a stylist, a designer. All in one. Whatever you need, I have. Whatever resources you need, I have. I am not the plug. I am the source. So, I mean, anything you need, anything you want to talk about, I mean, I am me. I don't really know what else to say. Everybody already knows me.
Man, you know
what? I'm just really the type of person where I get it done. If you need the job done, I'm the person to come see.
That's what's so good about this whole segment, that everybody that I'm looking for does every hairstylist. And I don't need my hair done, though. I ain't. You can put at a barber, pull up, you know what I'm saying?
I mean, you can get with me and I can get you right. Image is everything.
Yeah.
I totally agree with that.
I mean, and it's, you know, it's a new year's early. We can get something started. Get
I'm down with that. I'm down with that.
A makeover.
I mean, if you down for a makeover, I'm willing to give you the first
this
one.
This don't make me look like motherfucking James Brown and that little curly head, man.
Nah, you got to ask about my style. I'm going to give you grace.
Yeah, I know. I'm
going to update you, baby.
Man, if you're friends with this crazy motherfucker, you got to be good.
Oh.
Shane wild as shit, man.
Oh, man.
Well, I can't talk. I'm going to talk about you on my show. I got to talk about my mama on my show.
Excuse me.
Hi, by the way, Ma. My mama mad at me, but, you know, we should get over it. But,
And on the to the right of us.
That's my man. I'm going to let you get it for you, man. I know what you do.
What?
Go ahead.
No, it's for the audience. It literally is not for me. I already did my research. Tell the audience a little bit about yourself.
How y'all doing? I'm Brandon Moon, owner of King Amongst Kings Clothing. Hidden Info Clothing, CAC Films, you know what I'm saying? We're doing a lot of big things in the city.
See? For those who don't know. No, we appreciate you coming in. Like you talk about, it's all obviously it's to have this circle of people we can all turn to and call on and promote and wear and, you know what I mean, to be a part of, so that way the DMV can make its own splash in the stylist community, in the makeup community, maybe where... So it's not just music, if that makes mm-hmm. sense. You know what I mean? There's so much more to that.
Yeah, we definitely out here trying to be a part of the culture. Like, one thing the DMV is missing is, like, a real culture base. Like, somebody that come from the area that captivates every single person out here. The swag, the lingo, the dressing, you know what I'm saying? Everything.
Right.
Know? So, you know what I'm saying? That's what we trying to bring to the game. Something new, some flavor. You kick a heavy flavor.
You make a good point, because the person that we, or people that we, I mean, I'm from California, so it's interesting you say LA, but being here, you become a part of the culture.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? In my 10 years in this area, you pick up the swag, you learn to love it and absorb it, but the people that represent us as a community should also be drenched in that swag.
Yes.
Does that make sense?
Yes. Yeah,
so... You know, shopping from local designers and, you know, obviously, you know what I mean, taking pictures in those things and, you know, promoting those things. Do you think there's definitely a lag in that, or that we just don't have that at all, or do you think it's kind of like a budding, growing thing?
I mean, it's growing. Like, you know what I'm saying? You see, like, in mainstream, like, everybody is taking the flavor from this area mm-hmm. and taking it somewhere else and making it better. Like, when you are an artist or anything that you do out here, it's like you're running for president. You know what I'm saying? You got to shake hands and kiss babies.
That's true.
You got to know what the people want and give the people what they want. You know what I'm saying? But it's a lot of people out here that just in for themselves, so they don't really captivate the culture and shit. They don't really promote the culture.
Right.
It's just for self-growth and shit.
Exactly. And what people don't understand and don't get is once you give, you know, promoted yourself to the ends, and maybe you do actually make it. If your own like hometown doesn't mm-hmm. support you, why should anybody else? You know what I mean? Right. It's not about.
It's not true.
It is true.
That's not true.
I'm not saying that don't
My
support this
don't
person.
Don't support me much as Atlanta do, but I mean, it is what it is.
It's the point
you
I'm saying is
support
yes,
here.
You do. You need
people that support Wale when he was here, when he was doing open mics. He went to Atlanta, did his thing, moved down there, and
true.
Came back. It's true. It's very true.
It's, that doesn't make Wale who he is. Atlanta didn't make Wale, doesn't back Wale. I mean, obviously, he's lacking in the support system that he has here. But at the same token, Wale has come back to make amends with his community in order to
people
have
don't support
to
here
make those steps.
People don't support here till you be something.
I'm not saying that's not true. What I'm saying is that there needs to be a change where you can be successful by putting on your hometown and your environment and the swag that
okay.
it brings. That's my point.
It's a perfect example.
I just feel like you take care of the people will take care of you.
Correct.
Like, I never had no problem getting no support.
Exactly.
From
me neither.
You know what I'm saying? Because I'm just a real individual out here. You're like, I really touch my people. I show up at events that people be throwing. I do everything.
You sure do.
You know what I'm saying? Give away shirts free. You know what I'm saying? Like
you're doing yourself a huge, you know.
Because it's bigger than you.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? You're just a representation of the culture and shit, of the people here and shit.
Mm-hmm.
So when you come out trying to promote your brand, you got to give them the flavor that they already are.
Right.
But you know what I'm saying? In your way, in new fashionable ways or whatever it may be. You know what I'm saying?
Because the point that you did make is that the only way that to be successful here is to get out there and just show up.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Say hello to people, introduce yourself, go to a charity event, go to a fashion show, go to all these different things. Like, people get to know you throughout the years, and then you can call in favors and you can do whatever yeah. because you've shown that support. All you got to do is show up.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You don't even have, I mean, obviously we want you to spend your money with your local entrepreneur, but it means so much, and it's like a muted, you know, it's amplified if you just show up and like lend a hand or take a picture or bring somebody you know can link them up with somebody else.
I mean, because perfect example, you got the madnesses, the hobos, mm-hmm. the shooters, the all days, the players world, backyard. They still support backyard every day. Backyard playing somewhere every day, and people are there to spend their $40-$50 to get
right.
in that.
Still.
Joint. Still.
Mm-hmm.
20 years later, 30 years later, mm-hmm. still. So the support is here. It's just the product you giving them. Like, you got to give somebody a great product
yeah,
to want to buy into.
Absolutely.
You just can't just give somebody anything and be like,
expect
yeah.
expect them to buy it.
Yeah.
Well, there was a person that was on Facebook the other day, and she did a post, and she was like, every time she asks somebody that she knows for a product or service, you know, to do something, a clothing item or whatever, they don't show up or they take the money and they don't really actually finish the actual work. And she said, should I feel bad that I don't ever want to employ anybody locally again or my friends and blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, why take away from people who really are actually going to perform that product and service?
Yeah.
But at the same token, how bad should we should feel bad for her that not once but twice?
I mean, that's life. You know what I'm saying?
Should, yeah,
sometimes shit go through, sometimes it don't.
True.
You know what I'm saying? That don't mean you just stop doing what you're doing just because one mistake happened.
Do you think it's an issue within our community where people are promising goods, products, and services and not delivering?
You just got to be a great judge of character. Like, you know what I'm saying? It's on you. It's always buyers beware. You know what I'm saying? You have a choice. Nobody's forcing you to buy anything.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? You got to feel comfortable in the item that you're purchasing or the people that you're buying into.
I told her just to find another friend.
Yeah.
Keep going and keep asking.
People don't understand. Like, people get so caught up in their phones, they forget how to build relationships
exactly.
for real.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? People don't talk no more. We don't have casual conversations or intelligent conversations no more.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So that's the problem right there.
It starts right there. It's all about images and the looks, but what about the behind the scenes? What's really going on? So that's a very dope outlook.
I mean, I love the way DMV going with the clothing. I wear DMV clothing all day.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I got his stuff. I wear his. Ivana got on a Juice shirt right now. DMV, the deals move value. So, I mean, it's definitely a good movement.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Bay Man Society. Who sponsored me is, it's definitely good. I'd rather put on somebody here clothes than somebody else.
Right.
Not just because it's free.
Mm-hmm.
I appreciate that. Because I get the money. I mean,
it's one thing to get something for free, but also pay. I paid a lot of money over the course of the years for a lot of sweatshirts, t-shirts, you know, hats or whatever.
But just like you said, you got to have a flavor. You can't put anything on
your
back.
It's different now, mm-hmm. yeah. We would love to have people just say, hey, here's my stuff. You know, let's link. You know, and we, you know, we'd be proud and happy to wear that. Be proud and happy to do anything that supports this culture.
I don't think it's just a DMV issue. I think it's a worldwide
issue.
Sure,
that's for sure.
It's all over the world that people don't support their people, and that's just us as black people these days. Like, we don't stick together anymore. Mm-hmm. We'll have love for each other. We used to, back in the day, want to pick our brothers up mm-hmm. and our sisters up. You know what I'm saying? And now it's just like people want shit on each other so much. You know what I'm saying? It ain't about that. It ain't about who's doing the best. We all surviving out here. We all getting to the bag. And you know what I'm saying? If somebody down, just give them words of encouragement. It's not more or less material things you give somebody. Just some game
right.
will change somebody's life. I done changed a couple people's life by just giving them game. You know mm-hmm. what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And that goes a long way. You know, talk to your people, man.
This is a new generation. You know, yeah. this new generation needs more guidance, you know, yeah. and the world is changing. But at the same token, like I was telling the ladies, it's also changing for the better because we yeah. are now speaking up. And nobody is standing for everything and falling for anything so much as it kind of was in the past, I feel like. Yeah. And that's a beautiful thing, you know. But at the same token, you got to practice what you preach. There's yeah. a lot of talking about it, but no walking, you know. Yeah. A lot of talk, no walk. You know what I mean? So, what are you doing? Oh, live.
But nah, that's some good game. I mean, I like Moon because he's so young and so intelligent. Like you really know what he doing.
I'm
32.
I ain't
32.
That young
and
shit.
Younger than me. Yeah. And he got some good music. He didn't put it out yet. He didn't put good music out yet.
They should have brought. I know, right? That was anyway. Tell us about your music then.
Yeah, I mean, we have a lot of great music, like, coming, you know what I'm saying? But right now, like I always say in my interviews, we've just been focusing on building relationships with the people, you know what I'm saying, before we give them our product, right. you know what I'm saying? And I've been out here touching the people, like, showing up everywhere I need to be, you know what I'm saying, putting my face there, knowing that, you know what I'm saying, letting them know that I support them. Mm-hmm. I just don't want to say, support me and I don't support you, because I'll be looking crazy, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
So. You know what I'm saying? Most definitely. Really, I definitely come through. You know what I'm saying?
My man, every show I done hosted, he done showed up.
Yeah.
See? That's real support right there.
You know what I'm saying?
That's what's up.
And pay. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Right. And
And Paul Bottles with me.
So it's been, you really, the way to show your support is to not ask your homeboy for like a discount or, you know what I mean?
Say that again.
You know what I mean? Like you can still.
Say that again because that's church right there.
Right.
You ain't asking Louis for a discount.
Exactly.
You can't go to McDonald's and be like, man, let me get a double cheeseburger. Mm-hmm. I only got 39 cents.
Right. You know so why discredit or discount, somebody?
Pay to play, man. Yeah. God damn. Niggas be claiming making all this money, spend it.
Then when talk about it. Especially when it comes like to music. You got all this money, but you can't get it mixed in.
Too many cheap niggas with money.
Yeah. So, you know what I mean? You definitely, it's a huge support and it goes back into our community so everybody, gets something out of it. It's a good thing if we all try to, do what's best for each other.
Scratch each other back.
We have to, but we have to literally, and I think those of us who are now in our 30s and beyond who started off here in the scene and whatever, like we have to build these places for everybody to go and just to come out, come together and discuss these things or, have these seminars or bring something to the, And then let them know how they can do it too. You know, it's a spider web. That's what we want, like a huge circle for all of us to feed off of. And to do the right thing. So I got this idea in my head about bringing everybody together. This has been a great show because we've had so many amazing people.
Man, I'm trying to tell y'all before we talk to her, I had a lot of calls, but you were really good.
What?
Stop.
I was not expecting that.
I never had nobody. Like, I had a lot of co-hosts. And then we have our little arguments or disagreements, but you still here. I had to tell a co-host to step her game up, and then she left the show. You know what I'm saying?
Well, yeah. And also at the same token, I've been doing radio in here around D.C., Maryland, and Virginia, and each state for many, many years. So it's like, this is it's just a different platform, and I love it the most. Everything happens for a reason.
People say, "Oh, you got her on your show?" We do.
Definitely a threat. but very humble. And just as he was saying, and she was saying, and everybody's saying, like, I'm not from here. So to come and be an outsider, alien, or whatever, and just show up to people's events, you know, what was it, 5.5, almost 6 years ago, to just show up and be a part of Will Rap for Food and be a part of Santa Claus and to be a part of, you know, just going to Pure Open, you know, showcases and, you know, those things, showing up for charity events and just giving coats and driving hours and spending money and tickets and blah, blah. Now, as I'm older in this community, I'm able to, it's all the connections that I have made are amazing. That's what led me to go on tour and do all this amazing thing. So I'm just grateful, because if it wasn't for DC, Maryland, Virginia, and the love and the support and the culture and the beautiful artistry of the people that we have here, I wouldn't be who I am today. Mm-hmm. Thank you, bam. Oh, and I was a queen when I met you.
Yeah.
I guess I'll always be a resurrecting queen. Yeah. Anyway, so let's talk. So what do you... Stop. Okay, hold on. She's me. She got it. So...
I'm like, oh, okay.
What's your favorite thing to design?
For lack of better words, women.
Women. So do you sketch things, or do you have
So I sketch, but I more so style, and I have basically a team that I that basically help me with all my designs and my ideas and bring my visuals to life, because I don't sew. So I have people that sew for me. If I don't feel like drawing, I have somebody that'll draw for me.
That's important, too. Always have a team behind you.
Yeah, that's basically what I do. I operate as a team, mm-hmm. behind the scenes. I'm not really a public person. A lot of people think I'm a public person, but I'm really not. So I'm more so behind the scenes. And
but introverts are artistic.
I'm really not an introvert. No. I'm just, once again, lack of better words, I'm weird.
Just private.
Everybody that knows me knows I just like to lay back and do my own thing at my own pace, at my own vibe. I'm kind of like, if I'm going to do it, I'm going to do it. If I don't want to do it, I'm not going to.
True. Did you tell everybody where you're from?
I guess we say I'm here. I'm local DMV area. Alexandria and Avalon, California.
Alexandria, what, Virginia?
Alexandria, Virginia.
Where are you from? Well, actually, I was born in Alexandria.
He does not remember, but me and him used to kick it back in the day.
True.
I can't really tell you, but I'm going to show you some pictures of me and you.
Damn, that's crazy.
That's ABA right there. That's Alexander Fowler right there.
That's crazy, though. I'm all the Moon Brothers.
Yeah.
Del Rey, 6000.
That's him?
The Untouchables.
Yeah.
Charles Houston, yeah. Suggs. That's all up.
Interesting.
Yeah. But in between Alexander.
So how you feel about the buzz that Alexander making music-wise? Like, they have a lot of talented people.
Okay, so as far as music, I'm really not into the music scene. I'm really not a music person when it comes to, and I'm probably going to sound bad, local music.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not a local music fan.
Right.
I don't do the rap music. I don't do the go-go music. I'm not for all the loud, roddy.
So what kind of music do you like?
Jesus? Yeah, I'm all Jesus. I like R&B. I like some rap music, but the rap music I listen to what they call, I guess y'all call it now, the Bay Bounce beat. Bounce and trap music every now and then. Mm-hmm. Like, I'm one of them type people, like the Jesus song. And then if I'm feeling in the mood or if I need like an uproar real quick, I crank on some Jeezy for like a minute. Like, after a minute, though, it's not so good for me, mm-hmm. you know, because you got to learn the levels. And see, my levels ain't so good to where I can listen to trap music longer than a minute or two.
For sure.
So then, you know, I blast it to like 30. That's where the radio go, right? Like up to 30 or something. And then I turn it back down and that's it. But I think it's good, the culture that they're bringing. As far as what they're doing for the people, I'm into the rap scene, I guess, in for some artists mm-hmm. I'm cool with. So the fact that, like you say, the Santa Claus campaign, mm-hmm. very close to my heart. Will Rap for Food, very close to my heart. Top Dog Toys for Tats.
Hey, shout out Top Dog.
That's family right there.
Gangster.
Hey, watch yourself. Watch yourself now.
A whole lot of gang shit. Anyway,
hey,
moving on.
Excuse me.
Sorry, boo.
I'm saved, y'all. I'm really delivered.
Yeah.
I'm really delivered, y'all.
Sorry.
But no, just in all honesty, like character. As far as the yeah. But in all honesty, man, like I said, I'm not here for the music, but what they doing for the people. We got a sense of entitlement here in this DMV, man.
Exactly.
So we feel like because we make rap music, we make clothes, or we have something that they must buy. I don't have to do nothing for you.
Right.
What are you going to bring to me? And so that's where I'm at. Like, if I can touch the people, I already, my merchandise, anything I do, I don't really worry about anymore. I really want to know how I can get to the people. Mm-hmm. Let me bless the people and the rest going to come. So I love the rap scene for that. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And the people who are like, who are really about that instead of, oh, I'm down for my people. And then you have somebody like Mo Better who been begging for five years for these rap people to come together and y'all can't even drop $20. But I ain't going to get there right now.
Yeah, we don't
want to. But you know what I'm saying? Or you know what I'm saying?
Because Mo's not here.
Yeah. But y'all want to drop $350 or $400 on the table, but y'all ain't want to donate no coats up there on Rhode Island Avenue a couple of weeks ago. But we ain't going to get there either.
The one that Just Paul did.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
So, I mean, for the people who are really doing it and not to be seen, but really doing it, my hat's off to you. Because, I mean.
My man Mike Angelo did something very great.
Mike D'Angelo did
something. Oh, yes. Yeah. See, stuff like that.
Well, that's the point that she's making. You know what I mean?
Did an event for that young man and sat there and gave the whole bang, slide nothing in his pocket. Mm-hmm. He gave, and see, that's what I'm saying. But see, what we lack right now, for real, and this is how we miss out on success, is the integrity and the character of the people. People so caught up on this and that, but that integrity and that character, I'm trying to tell y'all, I make good money now. Credit score all right right now. But when credit score wasn't so high, when I really wasn't making no money, when I real life was trapping out my van and they had no store, let me tell you, my integrity got me into buildings my credit couldn't get me into. Mm-hmm. My character linked me up with these celebrities and these different people. Now I have sponsorships and endorsement. Like I say, I'm the plug, not because of me. It's because of my character and how I treat people. Mm-hmm. People love to work with me. Right. People are excited to see me. And you just, when you your character and your integrity is right, life is good. I'm not watching over my back. I'm not worried about where my next dollar going to come from. Not saying I have it like that, but because I just believe that I do right by people, that everything else is going to come to me. That's just life.
I can't, man. I'm so proud of you. Stop. What? The women and the men that you brought in here today.
Oh, man, I can't take the credit. I got to give Shane. Wow.
Just,
I wore Moon, but she did all that. I got to give her, I know, I have to give her
a pop. She just said, you're welcome.
She got the guests and everything. So,
no, that's amazing.
Nah, I mean, but it's like that, like, it's people that talk, and people know, like, Ron and Moon know, it's people that talk bad about me every day, and I still let them rock on my show, and I don't even perform on my show, and I still show the love.
In the end,
niggas
it's
bash me
you.
Every day, and I still show love, because at the end of the day, dog, this is God's plan, not mine. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Any day, God take care of everything. God take care of haters and everything. So it's no use to me saying, oh, no, you can't perform a show because we had a wrong. Go ahead and perform. But guess what? You're going to have to deal with that. Not me. I'm not going to block no blessings.
I mean, I'm a firm believer because of see where I come from and how I used to live my life. And I'm going to even say sometimes of how I live my life right now, sometimes I don't make the best decisions. But I try to tell people this one thing. There's no need for me to talk down to you. Because I know that I did bad, and I know that I had a praying grandmother, a praying friend. I had people to come and lay their hands on me. So the thing is, while you praying for somebody downfall, you never know who praying and uplifting them up. So why I'm going to let you win twice? I'm not about to pray for your downfall and then lose my blessing for wishing bad on you, and you still win. That's called a double loss, and I'm not in it for the loss. So in all actuality, it's just live your life. Don't worry about what nobody else is doing. And if you know that you're living your life the right way, you ain't got to worry about nothing else. When people worry about haters and worry about who said this and, oh, I'm not about to look out for this person or that crab in a barrel mentality, for real, you ain't living right. I ain't calling you out, but you not living right, for real.
Right.
But accountability, integrity, character, and accountability is where the success is. But since our people as a whole don't want to be accountable and feel like that the next man is going to be better than us or that our best friend or our man can't tell us nothing, we still stuck in the same place. So until we grow together and want to drop that knowledge and not act like we all masons in the secret free world of society, then we ain't going to never get nowhere. Nah, I ain't gonna preach today. I'm gonna let y'all have it. I ain't gonna preach today.
No, but we appreciate it. We only have a couple minutes left, so we want to make sure that people know where they can find you both.
Okay. Well, I can be found at Royal House of Style, 7812 Parston Drive, Forestville, Maryland.
Oh, that's right by Shamaco on your neck.
Uh-huh.
She's so cute. All right.
And my Instagram is Royal House of Style. What? My Facebook is LA Space what? Macon. If you're in the DMV area, that's where you can find me. I also have some other locations where you can find my items, but that's my prime location. If you're in Atlanta, you can find me.
I'll be in Atlanta in a couple of weeks.
Okay. Well, you can find us in Southwest Atlanta right now. If you're in, if you're a DMV artist or if you're a makeup artist, dancer, anything, you can give me a call at 202-534-8413. We have Club Platinum Atlanta. Okay. All right. Okay. Well,
We appreciate it. And we thank you so much.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome. And for you.
Well, you can find me on Instagram at I am Brandon Moon or on Facebook at Brandon Moon. You know what I'm saying? Check out our.
Hold on, guys. Let him.
Check out our merch. You know what I'm saying? We got a lot of shit on there. Come get some photos done. You know what I'm saying? Whatever, man. We turned up, man. Or you can just catch me in the street because we out here shaking hands and kissing babies, man. Believe that.
Yeah.
And that's what's up. You're a king, and we appreciate that.
No, we shaking hands and kissing babies. We showing love and support.
That's right.
That's what's up.
Well, I love the show, man. Like I said, I ain't got... Shout out to the whole DMV. Shout out to everybody that's rocking with me. Yeah. Like I said, Atlanta, man. February 17th.
February, Atlanta. That should be fun.
Tyler Peace Lounge.
All right, might as well.
Magic City Live.
So I want to go to Magic anyway.
You want to go to Magic City?
Yeah, anyway. We're still live on the air with this.
Need some employees.
So, yeah, right. See.
Yeah, there it is. No, I like Strokers too. Strokers my
when
shit.
When we get off there, it's different. No, but anyway, so February, Atlanta?
February 17th, Atlanta. February 24th, Twin Lakes. When that's being working,
and I think we're
going
to snatch the crown for best show.
And also, man, if y'all got some kids, man, we feeding all the kids for Bam Jr. birthday, February 10th at Chuck E. Cheese. Bring them on back, man.
You did say free.
It's tax season, so it's on us.
Oh, I don't have kids, but...
it's on us.
Can I come if I don't have kids?
Yeah, you can still come.
All right. Thank you for making
it. You gotta give him a lap dance, though.
Shut up, man. So we miss you, Andre. Congratulations again on your baby. We love you, and we're missing our DJ, but we appreciate the hard work of our resident DJ.
Mom, we had to bring him up to, we had to bring him up to speed, but, man, like I said, man, it's Coke Drive. Still bring your coats, man. We got like 2 boxes out there. Shout out to everybody. Donate. Also, we live in Star Impulse, man. Y'all need a car, whatever, man. Come holler at them. Tell them the Different Mind Show sent y'all. If I can get my little confirmation, you know?
Get out of there.
So we out of here, man. Y'all be safe. Y'all going out tonight, man. Backyard to Aqua with J.Y. and Nipsey.
Yeah, he said till 3:30, so.
Yeah.
I'm not going.
Yeah. Right.
So. So anyway, I'm MC Fran.
Bam 640, we in the building.
Each and every Friday, 9 p.m. on Vox Wave. Yeah. Power 37.3.
I ain't never found no one like you.
World is so cold, people even colder. So much stress though, hanging on my shoulders. My world, my journey, how do I move on? Before I'm done, bet you feel the pain in the song. Pushing for better days, at the end, only God can lead the way. Start off with Go-Go, BYB and JYB, shout out to BU and Big G. For believing in me, came a long way from being stuck in these streets. Mother was a hustler, father was a sucker. Look what they made, one humble motherfucker. Never give up, never will I stop. Told me in 2012, Different Mind will flop. People support me, haters can't stand me. Made something out of nothing. DC and nothing.